What Australian breeders want the majority of the time is speed, and early speed, and a horse of the calibre of Star Turn certainly offers that in more ways than one. Firstly, look at his physique, that great quality, strength and presence. Watch him move and you can see his great power not only in his hind quarter, but also through that great drive he has up front through the shoulder. Secondly, his pedigree suggests speed. He is a son of successful stallion Star Witness, a Group 1 sprinter at both 2 and 3, having won the Blue Diamond Stakes as a 2-year-old and the Coolmore Stakes at 3. Star Turn is also from a speed mare in Golden Delicious, a winner of no less than 13 races up to 1,200 metres, 5 of which were at stakes level. With his powerful looks and speed pedigree, it was no wonder Star Turn was fast early.
It's Star Turn a length in front of Tango Rain. Capitalist can't get there. Kentucky Miss out of her pocket, but Star Turn returns to the 3-year-old with a cosy win in the San Domenico.
He won the Piero Plate in November of his juvenile year before contesting both the Blue Diamond and Golden Slipper, where he finished 6th. But it was as a 3-year-old we really saw how much of a talented sprinter Star Turn was. Against older horses in the Scalacci Stakes, he travelled 3 wide the journey before Craig Williams literally just let him go on straightening and cruised to a 2¼ length win, without being shown the whip at all. His time for the 1100 metre journey that day was a slick 102.89. This is a race record for the Scalacci Stakes since it was brought back to the 1100 metre journey. He proved himself the most consistent 3-year-old sprinter of that season, having finished in the frame in the Group 1 Coolmore Stakes, as well as the Open Class Group 1 sprints of the Lightning Stakes, the Newmarket Handicap and the William Reid Stakes. Retired to stud in 2017, we saw his first crop head to the sales this year. Star Turn was an exceptional looking yearling himself, purchased by renowned judge Alan Bell. So it was no surprise to see him produce horses of equal quality, and this was reflected in his sales results.
Such a tough, sound, genuine, high-class racehorse with that real spark of brilliance that you have to look for in a stallion prospect.
At Magic Millions, he averaged just over 200,000 and sold to a high 550,000. Outstanding results for a stallion which stands for just 15,000 plus GST this season.
For 550,000.
What has pleased us most about these terrific sales results are the stables they have gone into. He will have progeny in the stables of Team Hawks, Peter and Paul Snowden, Chris Lees, Chris Waller, Kelly Schweder, Gay Waterhouse and Adrian Bott, Tony and Calvin McAvoy, Mick Price and Mick Kent Jr., Gerald Ryan, and many more leading stables around the country. We are not too far off seeing the first 2-year-olds off to the trials, and we are confident with who we have spoken to that a number of his progeny will be in attendance in these trials and the early races.